The detergent market in India is said to be worth 13,000 crore rupees and looks somewhat like this. It is divided into three segments: premium, mid-range and popular. The premium segment comprises brands like Ariel and Surf. The mid-range segment comprises Tide and Rin, and the popular segment comprises Wheel, Nirma and Ghadi. The market share of the detergents in the premium segment is 15%, and that of the mid-range and popular are 40% and 45% respectively. These brands are considered organized players in the industry and constitute 60% of the total market. The remaining 40% is saturated with regional unorganized players. Reports suggest that India's per capita consumption of detergent stands at 2.7 kg, the lowest in the world. In this video, we will explore the pricing, distribution, and marketing strategies adopted by the company behind Ghadi, the market-leading indigenous brand which traces its origin to 1985. Before we dive into Ghadi's journey, let's take a look at the history of the detergent powder. In 1930, German scientists developed synthetic detergents to overcome post-World War I shortages in key ingredients that were used for soap, animal fat, and vegetable oils. The other big advantage of synthetic detergents was that they were much better at washing clothes in hard water. They were also better suited for use by the textile industry. In 1957, the first Indian factory to manufacture synthetic detergents was set up by Swastik Oil Mills in Wadala, Mumbai. Even though the key ingredients had to be imported, they were still cheaper than importing finished detergents. In the 1960s, Hindustan Lever entered India, accelerating the shift to detergents due to the persisting shortages of vegetable oils, a key ingredient in soap. By the mid-60s, large corporates like Tata Oil Mills and Hindustan Lever established themselves in the business. Hindustan Lever had even started exporting to Russia. In the 1970s, shortages in vegetable oils increased along with the use of synthetic detergents. To promote the use among soap-using consumers in rural India, companies like HUL started conducting plays and puppet shows at mandis. HUL also introduced Rin Bar around this time. In order to conserve the use of vegetable oil, the Indian government classified synthetic detergents as a core industry. This was a major decision that would change the market forever. By 1985, Hindustan Unilever's brand Surf was the number one player in the detergent market in India. However, when Nirma was launched in 1969, targeting the middle and lower middle class customers with lower pricing, Surf was evicted from its number one position in the market. Since 1970, Muralidhar and Vimal Kumar Gyanchandani had been working in the family business of manufacturing and selling oil soap at Farukhabad near Kanpur. In 1987, inspired by Nirma's success, they silently entered the detergent market with Ghadi, which is Hindi for time or clock. The company was named Sri Mahadeo Soap Industries Private Limited, with the brothers delivering their products to dealers initially on a bicycle. It took almost 15 years for Ghadi to reach 500 crore rupees in sales, but in the next 10 years, it would add another 1700 crore rupees. In 2005, the company was renamed as Rohit Surfactants Private Limited, or RSPL, named after Bimal's son Rohit. RSPL ended 2011 with net sales of 2,200 crore rupees, out of which Ghadi contributed 2,083 crore rupees, with smaller soap and dishwashing brands like Expert, Venus and MR2 accounting for the rest. 25 years after starting operations, in November 2012, Ghadi became the market leader, surpassing brands like Surf, Veer and Nirma. So how did they go from a company that no one knew about to becoming a household name in India? Let's find out. Ghadi is the dominant player in the Tier 3 and Tier 4 segments. The brothers implemented innovative strategies like choosing an indigenous brand name and integrating consumer preferences. For example, Ghadi detergent would release extra foam which the consumers would associate with additional cleanliness. But what has greatly worked in Ghadi's favor is the sheer size of its home market, Uttar Pradesh, which contributes around 17% to the total FMCG sales in the country, according to market research firm the Nielsen Company. Moreover, the company expanded into adjoining markets as well, such as Bihar, Madhya Pradesh and Punjab, which along with UP constitute a third of the total consumer products market. The brand, which promised good quality for a reasonable price, targeted the middle and lower middle class sections. The company empowered local workers too by appointing them at every level in the company, even at managerial positions. This not only had a positive impact on the region, but also greatly reduced the company's employee costs. But how exactly did Ghadi beat Nirma? It never battled with the latter on the price front. In fact, it found a gap and took the audacious step of pricing Ghadi at a 10% premium over Nirma and Veer, 35 rupees a kg as against 30 rupees, with the product quality being better too. It was positioned just above mass brands like Veer and Nirma, but far below mass premium brands such as Surf and Tide. The company has a strategy of having large depots or small manufacturing units every 200 kilometers near the core markets, which helped in minimizing transportation costs. The products go straight from factories to dealers without any forwarding or clearing agents, cutting down on transportation time and manpower. From manufacturing to packing and distribution, everything is done in-house by the company. The company delivers its products through its own fleet of around 450 trucks. This integration gives them complete control over operations and product quality and greatly reduces the operational cost of the company. Ghadi also has a strong network of 3,500 dealers who are extremely loyal to the company, especially because of the higher profit margins it provides to them, 6-7% higher than the 5% margin which competitors provide in this segment. Although the company was based in a tier 2 city like Kanpur, they were no less tech savvy and even came out with a mobile app called M-Sales in 2011, which helps the dealers to book orders and track sales on real-time basis. This helped the company's sales force to gauge dealer demand accurately and ensure steady supply to the dealers. RSPL proved that one can be innovative without shelling out huge money on advertising. Since Ghadi was aimed at the common man, usually targeting housewives, the company avoided celebrity endorsements to promote the product, unlike its competitors. The promoters wanted the consumers to use the product for themselves and develop trust in it. The company spends 2% of its sales for marketing and promotion. It promotes the product at exhibitions, fairs, magic shows, road shows and local plays, especially in rural and semi-urban areas, where they encourage people to try the product. The magic shows were greatly successful in giving the brand good visibility in cities like Jaipur, Kanpur, Indore, Alwar and Kota. The company came out with memorable TV and print ads, such as the "Pehle Istemal Kare, Phir Vishwas Kare" tagline. It roused people's curiosity and encouraged them to try Ghadi. The quality of the product lent credibility to the tagline's claim, which then led to repeat purchases. The most recent campaign revolves around "Sare Mail Dho Dalo," which hints at removing dirt not just from clothes but also people's minds.
बुरा न मानो, होली है। हो, आपके तो कपड़े मैले हो गए। सॉरी।
ये मैल तो धुल जाएगा, पर आपके मन का मैल वो कैसे धुलेगा? अरे बुरा लगा। बुरा ना मानो, होली है।
जबरदस्ती को मस्ती का नाम मत दीजिए, होली की आड़ में मनमानी मत कीजिए। इस होली सारे मैल धो डालो घड़ी डिटर्जेंट की एक पहल।
टू ब्रेक थ्रू द क्लटर, द कंपनी डिसाइडेड टू यूज द रेलवेज टू प्रमोट द ब्रांड। द फर्स्ट ट्रेन कैंपेन घड़ी डिटर्जेंट एक्सप्रेस वॉज लॉन्च्ड इन 2008। The Lucknow Guwahati train's exteriors were painted with Ghadi branding running for 2 months. This was followed by the Pushpak Express, the Swarna Jayanti Express and other such trains connecting northern regions with both west and south of India, consistent with the company's geographical ambitions. Today, the RSVL Group is a 8,000 crore rupees diversified conglomerate. Ghadi is present in more than 20 states with a strong presence in North and West Indian markets. RSPL Group has shifted to Gurugram as part of its expansion plan. It manufactures its products through 34 units across India. A greenfield project for soda ash, which is a raw material for detergent, has been established at Koranga, Gujarat by RSPL Group. Through this backward integration, RSPL Group is planning to improve its market share in the detergent industry and to retain its position as a market leader. It is still a family-owned business with different members in charge of different sectors. This means that the decision-making is faster and risks can be taken without waiting for clearance. Honestly, I had no clue how big of a brand Ghadi is. I always had the impression that it was a much smaller brand compared to the likes of Surf and Tide, as these brands spend heavily on advertising. What are your thoughts on the strategies employed by Ghadi? Is it possible that another brand can do to Ghadi what it did to Nirma? Let me know in the comments. I would love to hear your thoughts on it. Please like and share this video with others if you've learned something new today. Subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified when I upload next.